lysergic acid formula 25 called LSD. A close friend told him LSD was psychedelic, mind expanding. Said it would give him fantastic new sensations and thrills. So Tommy tried it, and his friend was right. At first, the LSD made him sick at his stomach. But then Tommy began to hallucinate. The air began to be filled with rainbows. The very atmosphere seemed to be a moving current of multicolored particles which came streaming down around him. When he listened to the stereo, he saw colored particles floating out from the speaker. When he looked at the walls, they seemed to be melting. The pictures on the walls became liquefied with colors running down like waterfalls. It was sensational. Inside himself, Tommy felt sublimated, sort of suspended in space. He had a euphoric feeling of wonderful well-being. For some, it will be a scintillating and exhilarating ecstasy. For others, it will be repose, even stupefying. The cult of LSD users call any of these psychedelic experiences good trips if they don't end up out of control. But they never know when a bad trip will hit them. Just about the time a user begins boasting that he has become a real acid head and suffered no real ill effects, a bad trip can sweep him into emotional oblivion. A bad trip can send him wandering down the highway seeking to merge himself with some speeding automobile. Even on so-called good trips, the acid user often becomes a serious hazard to himself. His whole sense of reality becomes distorted. He thinks he can fly like a bird or walk on water. He can look at a crack in the sidewalk and shrink back as though it were a Grand Canyon. Or he can look down from the top of a skyscraper and have the feeling it is barely inches to the ground. Scientists suspect that the LSD has its greatest impact on that part of the brain which decodes and interprets sensory impulses. By paralyzing or scrambling these sensory signals, the patterns in the brain become flamboyant, twisted, unreal. Sometimes the user thinks he can smell or taste the sound of music, or, as was the case with Tommy, he thinks he can see the music. The capacity of the brain to associate the present with the past is impaired. Perfectly familiar objects may seem completely foreign or non-identifiable. At the same time, the most bizarre associations seem to cloud the conscious mind, so that a user can be looking at a person and suddenly gain the impression that that person is dissolving away or turning into some kind of a strange monster. As with all psychedelic compounds, LSD not only diminishes the instinct of self-protection and self-preservation, but it removes the natural inhibitions. By 1963, significant quantities of LSD were being bootlegged on certain university campuses. Its promoters described it as a genuine thrill potion, something real groovy. In fact, it was in 1963 that two professors were discharged from Harvard University for the alleged promotion of LSD among students. They were Mr. Timothy Leary and Dr. Richard Alpert. For several years, Dr. Leary had been experimenting with exotic mushrooms from Mexico, and when LSD came along, he boasted of becoming a regular user of it. He subsequently involved Dr. Alpert, and they were both discharged after it was allegedly determined that they had involved a considerable number of students in an institutionalized acid cult. After their discharge, Dr. Leary and Dr. Alpert set up an outfit called the International Federation for Internal Freedom. For a while, they operated in Mexico, but they attracted so much undesirable attention, the Mexican government became alarmed and asked them to leave. They thereupon returned to New York, where Dr. Leary procured a 64-room mansion in Millbrook, New York, which resembled a Bavarian castle. There, they set up a cultist colony called the Castalia Foundation. December 1965, Dr. Leary was arrested at Laredo, Texas for the illegal transportation of marijuana from Mexico to the United States. He was subsequently convicted and sentenced to 30 years imprisonment. However, the wheels of judicial appeal grind slowly, so Dr. Timothy Leary has remained at large on bond and has been enjoying unprecedented success in promoting his formula for a psychedelic adventure in acid ecstasy. In October 1966, a federal statute went into effect, making it a federal crime to manufacture or possess LSD and certain other prohibited drugs. However, the Supreme Court then ruled that the use of peyote as a psychedelic drug in the religious ceremonies of certain Indian tribes is a constitutional right which cannot be denied them. As one might have expected, Dr. Leary soon organized his own tribal religion, using LSD, peyote, and marijuana as part of the sacramental ritual. He called his new religion the League of Spiritual Discovery. According to an article in the New York Times of September 20, 1966, Dr. Leary was demanding that the courts treat him at least as well as the Indians and allow his followers to legally consume these so-called sacred drugs of LSD, peyote, and marijuana in the private shrines of their own home. Dr. Leary states that the goal of his new religion is to turn on, tune in, and drop out. Medical authorities point out that what an acid user really does is to degenerate gradually into a mental vegetable, without ambition, without goals, and without the will to struggle. Gradually, the user withdraws more and more from social contact as the inner core of his entire personality seems to wither away. Among young people, Dr. Leary continually pushes LSD as an esoteric stimulant. He says, quote, an LSD session that doesn't involve an ultimate merging with a person of the opposite sex isn't really complete. One of the great purposes of an LSD session is sexual union, unquote. Of course, Dr. Leary knows that this acid compound is actually a sex depressant. Why should a super salesman of his national stature be concerned with such minor details? To protect himself, he always suggests that if young people don't happen to receive the promised endowment of esoteric stimulation from LSD, it may be due to the fact that they were distracted by all the rainbows and vivid colorations during the hallucination period.